It's taken over a year, 13 months of patiently waiting, biding my time, just hoping and praying the right opportunity would present itself, and it has. It's finally happened. We now have all the pieces to build Hedron Alignment the way it was meant to be built. In this crazy world of snakes and vehicles and cats, Hedron Alignment will stand tall as the savior, the light at the end of the tunnel, the Hedron we all must cling to in our time of need. In this video, I'm going to deck tech for you the masterpiece that is Grixis Hedron Salvage. Hold on to your butts, it's about to be a bumpy ride. If you enjoy this deck tech and want more like these in the future, be sure to hit that like button, helps out a lot. Everything begins and ends with Hedron Alignment. 3 mana for an enchantment with Hexproof and the ability to scry for 2 mana, and then the trigger. Oh, that's why we're here. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may reveal your hand. If you do, you win the game if you own a card named Hedron Alignment in exile, in your hand, in your graveyard, and on the battlefield. For all intents and purposes, this card is our only win condition. We're basically looking at Exodia here. The entire point of the deck is to fulfill the alignment's wishes and align the Hedrons. Let's explore how we're gonna do that. Normally, we'd be worried about our little enchantment surviving on the battlefield, but thanks to Hexproof, there are a laughably limited amount of spells that can actually destroy it. So, getting it onto the battlefield, that isn't the problem. But to win, we need the alignment in our hand, graveyard, and in exile as well. Let's focus on getting it into our hand and graveyard next. This strategy is looking to dig through cards as fast as possible. With that in mind, we're running playsets of both Tormenting Voice and Contingency Plan. Tormenting Voice can help us discard an alignment or draw into one. Contingency Plan? This thing is brutally powerful here. It's a no-nonsense dig effect. You search 5 cards deep, see an alignment, let it go to the graveyard if you need to, or let it stay in your library to inevitably draw it. While Contingency Plan isn't direct card draw, we're spending most of our time searching for Hedron Alignment, so when you use this and reveal 5 cards that aren't the alignment, that's like cheating ahead in time. Contingency Plan is easily the most underrated card in this deck. Try not to remove it if you don't have to. 2 mana to go 5 cards deep, that is quite strong. We're also running a pair of Oath of Jace, and no, we have no Planeswalkers at all. Oath of Jace is powerful on its own as a draw 3, discard 2 spell. Many of our draw discard spells require us to discard as part of the cost. Oath of Jace doesn't force you to do that, and by drawing 3 and then discarding 2, it's been a much better option in testing than Cathartic Reunion, the next card on the draw discard list. I can't stress enough how tight a deck this has to be, and you need at least 10 cards that dig through your library. Simply put, even without Planeswalker interaction, Oath of Jace was the best of the bunch after Tormenting Voice and Contingency Plan. Another hand and graveyard enabler for the Hedron Alignment. Getting Hedron Alignment on the battlefield, in the graveyard, or in your hand, not all that difficult, really. The hardest part about the alignment's requirements is the exile zone. Getting the enchantment into exile has always been difficult, requiring the use of janky cards that only sometimes work. It's really just been a mess. But thanks to Aether Revolt and a rare no one has paid any attention to since release, exiling the alignment may not be so difficult after all. Say hello to Secret Salvage. That's right, the bottom tier. Crap hole rare no one ever wanted. This is our salvation. You get to target an alignment in your graveyard, exile it, then go get the rest of your alignments and put them into your hand. Talk about cutting out the middleman that is the rest of your deck. You do 80% of your work right here. Not only is getting the alignment into the exile zone the absolute hardest part of the combo, but you get to do that and you get the rest of your alignments brought right to your hand. Secret Salvage was made for this deck, and the additional efficient way of getting the alignment into the exile zone is what prompted this deck tech. Secret Salvage will save us all. Not only did Aether Revolt provide one of the best ways to enable the alignment, but Kaladesh wasn't far behind. Players see Lost Legacy and they see a card that hoses opposing combo decks. That's true, Lost Legacy does a great job of pressuring singularly focused strategies, but those strategies are usually prepared for Lost Legacy. What other players don't expect? The inclusion of Lost Legacy in the main deck to target yourself. If the salvage isn't enough, or you don't have an alignment in your graveyard to activate it, Lost Legacy will dig through your own deck and exile a Hedron Alignment for you. You don't have to take them all, only one. Lost Legacy is 3 mana to fulfill the exile clause on the alignment, easy as that. Best part? Unlike the salvage, it's flexible. It takes advantage of this 3-deck meta. If you don't need an alignment exiled, you can name whatever you want and probably wreck your opponent. Most decks are green-black, Saheeli Cat, or Mardu vehicles now, right? In a solved meta where the dominant decks are mostly known, cards like Lost Legacy get much better in the main deck. Perfect information is powerful. So Lost Legacy gets to find your win condition and put it in the most difficult zone to enter, and it can destroy your opponent's combo or important synergies game one seems decent to me. I cannot stress this enough. Without the additions of Secret Salvage and Lost Legacy, this deck couldn't function at a level necessary to warrant a legitimate deck build. Previous options were more unreliable and downright crappy, but these two cards? If Hedron Alignment ever stood a chance at existing, now would be that time. Thanks to these beautiful, beautiful exile spells, the heroes we both need and deserve right now are here. As you can probably tell, this is going to be relatively clunky, which means we need to fill the rest of the deck with ways to not die. We're running Harness Lightning and Fatal Push for some instant speed removal. While Revolt isn't going to be something that we can enable all that easily, it won't matter. We're looking to stall the game as long as possible, and that involves killing 1 and 2 drop creatures if need be. The entire goal of the deck is to simply not die by using the least amount of resources possible. It's hard to ignore one black mana instant speed removal that hits a ton of early and powerful threats. Look at these. I'll gladly include Fatal Push in a non-Revolt deck just to remove these. Harness Lightning doesn't really need justification. 2 mana for at least 3 damage at instant speed is going to do exactly what we need. Again, low cost, 3 damage kills a lot of what we don't like, pretty easy inclusion here. Our last piece of creature removal is Yhenny's Expertise, one of my favorite new cards. There are some decks where this is going to be a blank, but against many Mardu vehicle strategies, believe it or not, or green-black decks, this thing is a house and it lets you cast an alignment for free, which is just good value. We're not running a playset or anything crazy like that, but the Expertise is as close as we're going to get to a legitimate board wipe in this strategy, and at 4 mana with a free 3 mana spell under it, it's definitely the best we're going to get here. We're also running 3 Disallow for some disruption. In addition to being a solid counterspell, Disallow has grown infamous for countering activated abilities, especially the ones on Planeswalkers. It's a great main deck answer to the plethora of Planeswalker ultimates that threaten Standard. And since our removal package has a very specific purpose, we lack Planeswalker interaction. So Disallow will either stop them from being played, or prevent them from using their ultimate, which they will surely get to if we don't end the game fast enough. Not like we're swinging in for heavy damage, you know? Anywho, Disallow helps keep the opponent honest even when we're trying to be dishonest. It's a good card. The deck also includes 6 creatures. We'll begin with 3 Baral, Chief of Compliance. This thing is a maniac, totally underrated. While we are only running 3 counterspells, we're not running Baral for his triggered ability. We're running him for his insane cost reduction. This deck contains 25 instants and sorceries, most of which are 2 or 3 mana. Being able to cast our powerful spells for 2 mana or even 1 mana, that's absurd. Every game tested with this deck went much better when we had Baral on the battlefield. His 3 toughness is great to block early attacks. He's pretty unassuming, believe it or not, so players don't remove him as quickly as you might think. And if you get even a turn or two of cost reduction out of him, you can end up playing twice as many spells as you would have normally. I know you're tempted to make his trigger more useful, but trust me, you do not need it. That cost reduction ability is ham steak awesome. Love him in this deck. The last creature in the deck occupying another 3 slots is Thing in the Ice. Again, we're running 25 instants and sorceries. Thing in the Ice just makes sense. Not only does it provide a powerful wall to fend off early attackers, most of which are at 3 power or lower, but it also provides inevitability. If your opponent can't remove it in time, it will flip very easily, and they'll be forced to start all over again, minus vehicles, but you get what I mean. It sets them back a turn or two, which is the most important thing. Remember, everything you're doing is meant to delay the game. Thing in the Ice isn't meant to win the game, it's meant to extend it. Force your opponent to use their resources to deal with it. It's especially powerful post-board when they take out most of their removal. There's really a no-win situation for them with this popsicle. They can keep removal in and blank against 54 cards in your deck, or they can remove it and not have an efficient way to deal with Thing in the Ice. It's a beautiful place to be. You only run a few creatures, but they are good. Land base is pretty simple. Playsets of Aether Hub, Choked Estuary, and Foreboding Ruins are our non-basics. Aether Hub is that great interaction with Harness Lightning, so that's just another reason to run the burn spell. And the 2 duels provide some much-needed black support, as most of our basics are blue. 23 lands in total, 7 islands, 1 mountain, and 3 swamps, plenty of red, blue, and black sources to go around. Hedron Salvage is designed to do two things. First, win using Hedron Alignment, obviously. Your goal is to get this ridiculous enchantment into every zone you can. Second, delay the game until you can complete your first task. Remember, your goal isn't winning the game with a flipped thing on the ice. You win the game with Hedron Alignment, and to do that, you're going to need to delay the game long enough to get it into your exile zone in addition to the other zones. So when you try this deck out, please remember that you losing on board is going to be the status quo pretty much every game. You will never be ahead on board. Your opponent will always play more proactive cards than you. It will never look like you're gonna win until you win. So use your removal early and often, kill everything you see, keep your life total above zero, and prioritize getting your Hedrons. Because if we're being honest, there's really nothing else for you to do, right? Come on, I believe in you. If we're talking sideboard, you're looking at some cookie-cutter suggestions. Dispel, negate, even revolutionary rebuff for any deck trying to disrupt you in any way. Lost Legacy is a pain, and you need the counter magic to deal with it, so be prepared. Another Fatal Push doesn't hurt, maybe some shocks for the really low-to-the-ground red-black aggro decks that are trying to sneak into Tier 1. Shock wrecks them just fine. While the deck is unique, the sideboard options are quite established. Go with the best available. So what do you think? How do you feel about Grixis Hedron Salvage? I gotta say, there is nothing like winning off of aligned Hedrons. There's legit nothing like it. If only to live that dream, you should consider trying this deck out. I would love to hear what you have to say about it. Had your own alignment run-ins, ran an alignment deck yourself, please leave all your thoughts below and we'll talk about it. I do hope you enjoyed this video. As always, thanks for watching and we'll see you next time. This video is brought to you in part by TCGPlayer.com. If you want to build this deck, many of the pieces are quite affordable, thank goodness. Right now, you can get copies of Baral Chief of Compliance for $1.90. $1.90. How cheap is that? Baral is a powerful card, not only in Standard, but Commander as well. You get two formats worth of power for a couple dollars. So easy. Not a fan? How about Hedron Alignment in all of its glory? Ready for this? 13 cents. 13 cents. 13. Come on, come on. I could find that amount of money in my couch cushions for goodness sake. A full playset will cost you under a dollar. It's just so cheap. If you want to build a deck, it's right here for you. Click the links. We all win. Enjoy.